Hi, welcome to Sunil Maths Tutorial. Abstract Algebra Group Theory Classes. Let us solve some problems. First one, if f maps g to g, g bar defined by f of x is equals to 1 if x greater than 0 minus 1 if x less than 0, where capital G is equals to non-zero real numbers and g bar is equals to 1 comma minus 1 are groups with respect to multiplication. Prove that f is a homomorphism and find kernel f. Yes, given that capital G is equals to set of non-zero real numbers, it is nothing but R minus 0. Set of non-zero real numbers means other than 0 and all real numbers other than 0. So capital G is equals to R minus 0 and G bar is equals to 1 comma minus 1. Very clear, G and G bar both are groups with respect to multiplication. G, G bar both are groups with respect to multiplication. There is a function F that maps from G to G bar. Defined by, you observe that f of x is equals to 1 if x greater than 0. Minus 1 if x less than 0. Because in the domain Z, it is the set of non-zero real numbers. There is no 0 in this set. So, no question of about defining x is equals to 0. No question about the function f of x defined at x is equals to 0. Because the domain G does not contains 0. So, you have to show that it is a homomorphism and also find kernel f. We prove this problem in three cases. Let us take the first case. Any two elements x, y belongs to capital G. Let us take any two elements x, y belongs to G and both x greater than 0, y greater than 0. If both x greater than 0 and y greater than 0 implies as xy also greater than 0. The product of two positive numbers is again a positive number. This is case 1. Please observe that. In this case, you observe that since x greater than 0 implies as f of x is equals to 1. Again, since y greater than 0 implies as f of y also equivalent to 1. Again, since xy greater than 0 implies as f of xy is also equivalent to 1. Observe the definition. F of x is equals to 1 if x greater than 0. F of x is equals to 1 if x greater than 0. Because x greater than 0, f of x is equals to 1. Y greater than 0, f of y is equals to 1. Xy greater than 0, f of xy is equals to 1. It can be written as 1 into 1. Very simple calculation. Again, it can be written as f of x because 1, f of y, 1. Therefore, we conclude that f of xy is equals to f of x into f of y. F of xy is equals to f of x into f of y. This is case number 1. Observe that. Next, case 2. Second case. Let us take any two elements x, y belongs to capital G such that both less than 0, such that x less than 0 and y also less than 0. X less than 0 and y less than 0, both are negative numbers, which implies their product must be greater than 0. Because of the product of two negative numbers is a positive number. Again, since x less than 0 implies f of x is equals to minus 1. Y less than 0 implies f of y is equals to minus 1. XY greater than 0 implies f of xy is equals to 1. By definition of 1. This 1 can be expressible as minus 1 into minus 1. Minus 1 into minus 1. You can substitute these two points, f of x into f of y. Because f of x is equals to minus 1, f of y also minus 1. Therefore, we prove that f of xy is equals to f of x into f of y. You observe that? Already we prove that f of xy is equals to f of x into f of y in case 1. Now we prove that f of xy is equals to f of x into f of y in second case. Let us prove the third case. Let us take third case. Let x comma y belongs to capital G such that x less than 0 comma y greater than 0. X less than 0 comma y greater than 0. So write which implies as xy is less than 0. Xy is less than 0 because we know that the product of one negative number and one positive number is again a negative number. Negative into positive, which gives a negative number. So, right, let us continue our calculation. Now, since x is less than 0, which implies f of x is equals to minus 1, y greater than 0, which implies f of y is equals to 1, and xy less than 0, which implies f of xy is equals to minus 1. Yes, this minus 1 can be written as minus 1 into 1. You observe that what is minus 1? F of x and f of y 1. F of x into f of y. Please observe that. Therefore, we prove that. F of xy is equals to f of x into f of y. If we take x greater than 0 and y less than 0. If we take x greater than 0 and y less than 0, then the same result holds as it is. Therefore, from case 1, case 2 and case 3. Therefore, from case 1, 2, 3, we have from case 1, case 2 and case 3, we have f of xy is equals to f of x into f of y for all x comma y belongs to capital G. This shows us f maps G into G dash G bar is a homomorphism. Yes. And then you have to find kernel of the mapping also. Let us find that. Now kernel f is equals to set of all elements x belongs to G such that f of x is equals to E, comma where E is identity element in the codomain Z bar. So which is equals to x belongs to capital G such that f of x is equals to 1. What is the identity element in G bar? What is G bar here? G bar is the set of two elements only, 1 comma minus 1. Among these two elements, 1 is the identity element. So that is simple. X belongs to capital G such that f of x is equals to 1. What it means? F of x is equals to 1 only if x greater than 0. What it means? Kernel f is equals to the set of all positive real numbers. Which is the required one. Observe that. Simple and tricky problem. Practice this problem. It's all one more problem. Next problem. Let capital G with respect to plus is a group of real numbers under addition of real numbers under addition, and G dash with respect to dot is a group of positive real numbers under multiplication and let F maps G into G dash be a mapping defined by f of x is equals to e power x show that f is a homomorphism and find kernel f Now the simple and easy problem, let us solve this. You observe that capital G with respect to plus is a group of real numbers under addition. They given that G with respect to plus is nothing but real numbers with respect to plus be the group of real numbers under addition and the second one, G dash with respect to dot means the set of all positive real numbers be the group of positive real numbers under multiplication and they given that F is a mapping from G to G dash defined by F of x is equals to e power x Please observe that the domain capital G is a group under addition and the codomain G dash is a group under multiplication. Therefore, the homomorphism condition becomes f of x plus y is equals to f of x into f of y. Because the domain is a group under addition and the codomain is a group under multiplication. You have to use addition here, you have to use multiplication here. Observe that. So let us take any two elements, x comma y belongs to G, then f of x plus y is equals to e power x plus y, simple calculation, e power x into e power y, which is nothing but f of x e power x, f of y e power y. Therefore, this condition implies as f of x plus y is equals to f of x into f of y, for all x comma y belongs to capital G. Therefore, G is a homomorphism. From G to G dash. Observe that. You have to find kernel of the mapping also. Kernel F is equals to the set of all elements X belongs to capital G, which satisfies the condition. Where E dash is identity element in G dash. G dash is a group under multiplication. So which is nothing but x belongs to capital G such that f of x is equals to 1. F of x is equals to 1. Observe that. What is f of x? E power x. What is f of x? E power x. X belongs to capital G such that e power x is equals to 1. F of x is equals to e power x. So e power x is equals to 1. Those elements which satisfies the condition. Those elements which satisfies the condition. X belongs to capital G and e power x is equals to 1. They belongs to kernel of the mapping. Observe that. Practice these two problems.